What's up, everyone? My name's Nick Savino. I'm a videographer and content creator in the Philadelphia area of Pennsylvania. This is video number 4 of a series I'm doing all year long where I show you how I do some of my photo and video work and sharing my journey as a videographer and content creator. Now, for this video, a couple weeks back, I had posted a photo on my Instagram of a plane flying over me on the roof. Now, if you're unaware of the photos I post on my Instagram, I post a lot of travel content as well as photo composites that I make inside of Photoshop. Now, some examples I'm gonna show right now, but this is the type of work that I love to do. And when I posted the photo of myself with the plane flying over me, a lot of people were wondering how I did it. So in this video, I'm gonna be showing you a step-by-step breakdown inside of Photoshop on how I created that particular photo. So if you're interested in seeing the process on how I did it, continue watching and follow along, and let's jump into Photoshop. Okay, cool. So now we're inside of Photoshop. And as you can see, this is the final composite that I created that I had posted on my Instagram. And I'm just gonna click these eyedroppers here just to give you a better idea on the elements that I used to create a photo like this. So this is the raw photo. And on top of all this are the elements that I used. So this is what we're gonna be making. So I have all the photos that I used to make this right here. This is the final version. Now I have an airplane, the raw picture of me laying on the roof, the runway, a really cool sky with clouds, and another valley with a mountain range in the background. Now I found all of these photos on a site called Unsplash.com. Unsplash is the perfect site to use when you're making photo composites like this. All the photos on the site are completely free to use, and there is a copyright-free license on every single photo. So you don't have to worry about any copyright claims and you can do whatever you want with the photos. So if you're doing stuff like this, I highly recommend Unsplash.com, and the photos are in super high quality, which is also great. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the first raw base layer and we're gonna bring it into Photoshop, and we're gonna click this little lockbox and unclick that so it's a free layer. Now, what we want to do is we want to get rid of the background of this photo. We just want to keep ourselves that's in the foreground. So to do that, what we do is we go to this polygon lasso tool. So we click and hold and then select the polygon lasso tool. And we're going to cut out basically the entire foreground of this photo. Now, for sake of time, I'm gonna do a really rough sketch of this. Obviously, if I was doing this to post or for a client, I'd be a lot more nitpicky. But for time, we're just gonna make a rough sketch along the roof here, and I'll be real quick. I'm gonna go around my knee like that, down along the roof, up again, get the gutter in there, and then we're gonna just bring this all the way around and connect it. So now we have a selected mask. And to view that, we're gonna go up to select and mask, and this is what it would look like without the background. And the options on the side here, we're gonna, you can feather it out if you want. So I like to feather out just a little bit, and I usually bring the, I shift the edge down just a little bit. And then you're gonna hit okay. And then it's selected, and you're gonna go down and click this little rectangle with the circle on it, which is the mask button. Click that and bam. So now you have nothing in the background and we have just me laying on the roof. Now, obviously this, it gets a little nitpicky in between here with the deck and over here. So obviously if I was posting this or something like that, I would go in, I would remove that as well. But for the sake of this tutorial, we're just gonna keep moving forward. So the next thing you wanna do is bring in your next photo, which is this runway. Now, the most important thing when making photos like this is to make sure that the photos you select to composite all have the same perspective. That way it will look the most realistic. So based off of these photos, the photo of me on the roof, it's facing down, almost looking out into the area. The photo of the runway is the same exact perspective as that. So when you're doing stuff like that, keep that in mind, and it's the most important thing to make your photos look great. So once you've imported the second photo, you're gonna click it and you're gonna bring it down below the layer, the base layer, and we're gonna reposition that. You can scale it up, maybe make it a little bit bigger, and we're gonna drop it in just like that. And that looks good. Perfect. So once that's placed in there, what we wanna do is we wanna get rid of the sky of this hill photo. So to do that, we're gonna use a different tool this time. We're gonna use the magic wand tool. So click, hold, and bring down this little drop button. And we're gonna make sure that the runway is selected, and we're going to click on the sky. Now, the thing about the magic wand tool is it selects areas of high contrast. So this photo with the runway is perfect for that because it has a very white sky and a dark green hill, which this line here is high contrast. So that works perfectly. So we're gonna click the sky and bam, it perfectly makes a mask around the hill. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go up to select a mask, but this time it gets rid of the hill instead of the sky. So cancel that and go to select inverse to make sure the mask selects the hill. Now we can go to the selected mask and it gets rid of the hill. So we're gonna feather that out again just a little bit and shift the edge down a bunch. Looking good, hit okay. And now we can do the same exact thing, go down to the right bottom hand corner and click the mask button. And now that sky is removed as well. Cool, that looks great. So moving forward, now we're gonna bring in the valley. It's the same type of perspective. The photos match. We're gonna bring this to the very bottom as well. And we're gonna reposition this, maybe scale it up a little bit. Reposition it so it's like that. Perfect. Okay, that looks great. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna import the sky. Okay, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna keep the sky on the top of all the layers, and I'll show you why in a sec. So we're gonna scale it up a little bit like that, maybe a little bit more. Okay, perfect. Now instead of cutting out any other layers or any other sky to replace it, we're gonna do another different way to remove part of this sky image to make it all blend together. So the first step is we want to go down and hit the mask button again, and it brings up a mask option. Then what we wanna do is we wanna go select our brush tool, and we're gonna go up and make this the size somewhere around 500 or so. That looks good. And make sure the hardness is all the way on zero, so that way it's a very soft brush. Then what you want to do is make sure that your color is selected on black as it is. And what that does when it's selected on black is it removes part of the image. Black equals remove, remember that. And white, if you flip this, white is fill, so I can fill that back in just like that. So in this case, we want to get rid of the sky, so we're going to make sure black is selected. And before we get rid of the sky and paint it away, we want to bring the flow down to about zero, between 0 and 20%. So I'm going to do like 16% should work good. And what the flow does is it slowly takes away the image. And the more you paint over it, the more it gets rid of it. So it really works as a great way to blend certain images, especially the sky. So we're gonna start painting away the sky photo here and reveal the photo that's beneath it, which in this case is the mountains. And look at that, just keep painting it away and bam, you have a completely different sky. So if we select that, and no one would ever tell the difference. Cool, so the last thing we wanna do is we wanna import the plane. We're gonna drag and drop that in here. Again, the perspective matches because a plane would take off from that runway and fly up over the house. It wouldn't make sense to have a side photo of a plane because it just wouldn't look real. So import the photo of the plane, and we're gonna use the magic wand tool because again, it's an area of high contrast. We're gonna select the blue. It automatically makes a cutout of the plane. And we're gonna go to the select a mask option. Oops, again, you have to inverse it. So go to select, inverse, go to the select a mask option, and we're gonna feather it a little bit, and we're gonna bring the shift edge down, hit okay, go down to the right corner and hit the mask button, and now the plane is removed. But we have all this other gunk down here. So to remove that, make sure our mask layer is selected on the airplane. select the brush again that we used to remove the sky, but make the flow 100%, so in one wipe it gets rid of all of that, and just erase it, and there you go. So now you have this plane here, and you can position it however you want. You can scale it up, make it a little bit bigger, and now there is some blue sky still in here from the previous image, so to get rid of that, you can just select it with the magic wand tool again, and select the mask, like that, and remove it. That's all it takes. Select the blue there with the magic wand, it makes a selection, go back to your brush tool with the black, and just paint it out. And perfect, now you have the plane in, you can position it however you want, and there you go. Cool. So that is the basis on how you create photos like this, and my process on how I create composites inside of Photoshop. If you found this video interesting and if you think you learned a lot, please let me know. I'd love to hear about it. And if you think about making any photos like this and do create something, please share it with me. I'd love to see it and I'd love to hear your feedback. My name is Nick Savino and I will see you in the next video, and continue to follow your passion.